Hey everybody. So I have some concerns that has been scratching the back of my mind about the PlayStation 5 and the whole backwards compatibility thing. Sure, yes, we all want full backwards compatibility from PlayStation. We already know we have PlayStation 4 backwards compatible with the PS5. That much has been confirmed for certain. But as for PlayStation's 3, 2, and 1 generations backwards compatibility on the PlayStation 5, that's where I'm worried about. Because from what I heard over on Mystic's channel about the whole topic for the whole backwards compatibility thing, which I don't think this ever came across to his mind like it has me. Maybe it hit some of you guys as well. I'm not entirely sure. Let me know in the comment section below. But I will also, before I get onto the butt, I also will post a link in the description below to the original video of Mystic's video when he talked about this whole backwards compatibility thing. He's a great channel. If you do what he says and you get lucky, you'll pretty much get 10 bucks for PlayStation Network. Pretty much buy your games for free, essentially. He's buying you your games. Now, on to the topic at hand. When he mentioned about backwards compatibility for the PlayStation 5, he also mentioned about how PlayStation Now and how they're constantly trying to update their servers on that. Well, not necessarily servers, but is he in a way of how he talked about it. It makes me a little concerned because if they're trying to work on PlayStation Now content and stuff like that, which is basically a pseudo backwards compatibility for a subscription fee. If they are dedicated to trying to work on PlayStation Now onto the PlayStation 5 as well, then there wouldn't be any need to have full backwards compatibility for PS3, 2, and 1 onto the PlayStation 5. And if they did, then there would be, as far as I can see, this is just how I see it. You guys, if there is something different or if I have something wrong here, go ahead, let me know in the comment section below. I will listen, I will comment back, I will be more than happy to discuss, chat a little bit on the topic. But yeah, if I have anything wrong, just let me know. But as far as I'm concerned, this PlayStation Now subscription thing might end up killing off any other backwards compatibilities for the PlayStation 5 when it comes to the first three generations. But as far as anything else goes, I am still at the very most, or at the very least, rather, happy that we have backwards compatibility for the PlayStation 4 onto the PlayStation 5. So, but if they do end up doing backwards compatibility for all the previous generations from 4 to 1, then, like I said before, in the way I see it, there will be little to no reason to have PlayStation Now subscriptions unless it's just to, like, basically rent a game as if it were the new blockbuster, which isn't exactly a bad thing. It's just no one would want to do it as often, I guess, unless they want to try some games for a little bit that they haven't seen before, heard of, but never played before, and just want to try out before they exactly go out looking on eBay or Amazon for said games, just to find and buy the game because it's that good of a game to them, in their opinion. They found it really fun. Or if they didn't like it, hey, at least they tried it. They know what to expect before buying it. I can see that for a PlayStation Now if there's full backwards compatibility for the PlayStation 5. But, I don't know. It does have me concerned in the long run for PS5's future for backwards compatibility. And if so, only time will tell. I do not have any definite predictions about it. It's just my thoughts and concerns about it. So I don't know. Do I have it wrong? Am I overthinking it? let me know, comment section below. I will be chatting with you guys. Let me know your thoughts. If you agree with me, if you disagree, that's fine. It's all relative. I mean, we can only know officially when they announce it for PlayStation 5. So I'll be constantly looking up, trying to find more stuff about PlayStation 5. Whether some YouTubers have already posted on it, I'll look it up on Google searches if it's there. I'm not much for looking at articles all too much. I have a certain point of a, well, there's a certain extent of my motivation that will allow me to research into stuff. Let's just put it that way. But if other YouTubers have seen into that already and they posted videos about it and officially confirmed that there is full backwards compatibility for PS4, 3, 2, 1, or there is just PS5, 4, hey, at least we'll know in the long run. I'll be watching those videos and I will, we'll see if my prediction is right or wrong. Or not prediction, but concerns are right or wrong. As for right now though, I'm not going to get myself too overly hyped about this backwards compatibility thing. Although I am hyped right now for PS5's backwards compatibility for the PlayStation 4. That is awesome in itself. All I can really say. So if you like this video, go ahead and click on that like button. If you like me, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. And don't forget to ding the bell for more notifications of my upcoming videos in the future. And if you think someone else will like this video like you did, or enjoy this video as you did, go ahead and click on that share button and share with your friends and family who will also enjoy. And don't forget to check out my Twitch, Twitter, and if you wish to support me, Patreon page, which will be in the link description below. Love, peace, chicken grease, everybody.